Today we're going to talk about bananas. Now I need to finish eating this. Even though most berries we know of today are mainly tiny and round, not all of them are. True berries are simple fruits that stem from one flower and one ovary, usually with multiple seeds, and that's exactly what a banana is. Oh, and get this, strawberries are not classified as berries, in the botanical sense anyhow. The average person in the UK eats 10 kilograms or 22 pounds of bananas a year, which is about 100 bananas. In the US, bananas are the most popular fruit, right above apples. In 1970, 7 pounds of bananas were consumed per person. This raised to 10.4 pounds in 2010, however, other sources say the average American eats roughly 25 pounds. I personally eat about 730 bananas a year, which really isn't that much. Some fruitarians eat more than 3,000 bananas a year. Bananas were first domesticated in Southeast Asia and Papua New Guinea. Archaeological and paleo-environmental evidence at Cuck Swamp in the Western Highlands province of Papua New Guinea proposes that the cultivation of bananas dates back as far as 7,000 years ago, and possibly as far back as 10,000 years ago. There are also texts references to bananas in Islamic poems and hadiths near the beginning of the 9th century. In the 10th century, there are texts about bananas in Palestine and Egypt. It then goes into North Africa and Muslim Iberia. If this is true, then the likelihood of humans using fruit as a staple food for thousands of years is even more promising. Those soft, sweet, and nearly seedless bananas you are eating today are mainly from the Cavendish group, named after William Cavendish. The Cavendish plant was grown in the Derbyshire Estates hothouse in 1830, over 180 years ago. Allegedly, this happened because the head gardener, Joseph Paxton, was apparently inspired after seeing a banana plant on a Chinese wallpaper in one of the 175 rooms in the home. He then got access to an imported banana species. I actually got into hydroponics after I saw someone grow a dwarf banana tree hydroponically. I thought it was so cool! That was also the week I learned Miracle-Gro does not work as a hydroponic nutrient. There is a threat to this food that us health enthusiasts love so much, and it's called the Panama disease. In the 1950s, the Gros Michel banana was nearly destroyed worldwide by the Panama disease. Panama disease is a fungus that is resistant to conventional agricultural fungicide. Cavendish is asexual, which means all of the plants are cloned descendants from one plant. This is why you don't spend your time spitting out seeds when eating one. The seeds are nearly microscopic now in most of the types of commercial bananas. Since they are clones, they cannot develop a resistance to disease. Once the disease figures out how to kill one plant, it then can kill all of them. If you're going to eat one fruit, you may want to pick bananas, as they seem to be close to a perfect food. Bananas are relatively nutrient and calorie dense, so I consider them a class 1 superfood in my book. When bananas are unripe and green, they are actually starchy compared to ripe bananas that contain simple sugars. This means green bananas contain polysaccharides, which are complex carbohydrates composed of long-chain sugars. They take longer to absorb and be utilized by the body. This can be useful information for diabetics that have trouble with simple sugars but still want to receive the tremendous list of health benefits from the fruit. The downside to this is that unripe bananas are harder to digest and contain less antioxidants compared to the spotted, ripened ones. That starch can also act as a prebiotic to feed beneficial bacteria in the digestive tract, which is good. Being a prebiotic alongside fiber greatly aids in digestion. A randomized controlled trial was done to learn the effects of banana consumption of fecal microbiota. The study revealed that the banana group had significantly lower gastrointestinal symptoms compared to controls. The consumption of bananas had no adverse effects on evacuation patterns. They concluded bananas are a well-tolerated eating behavior that may induce bifidogenesis in women experiencing weight problems. This will obviously be useful for men as well. According to research, the mean postprandial blood glucose response area to white bread was significantly higher compared to underripe and overripe bananas. It was found that bananas contain dopamine at high levels in the peel and pulp. Dopamine acts as an antioxidant and is crucial to support good mood, motivation, and attention. Tryptophan is also found in bananas. Tryptophan is a precursor to serotonin and melatonin. Serotonin is also responsible for supporting good mood, and melatonin is needed for proper sleep. Bananas mainly consist of fructose, glucose, and sucrose, which can increase energy levels and stabilize blood sugar, which is crucial for getting through the day. Bananas contain numerous amounts of vitamins, minerals, and even amino acids. This makes them a better alternative to processed electrolyte drinks and vitamin waters. Instead, you can make a banana smoothie. You'll get a lot more electrolytes from bananas compared to those blue and red dyed high fructose corn syrup electrolyte drinks. Ugh, why? Some of those energy drink companies even try to add caffeine and herbal extracts to their drinks for an additional energy boost, which in my opinion is done with utterly poor herbalism in mind. Let's not have a heart attack from our energy drink. Since bananas are high in potassium, it will actually protect your heart rather than stimulate it and increase the potential risk for a heart attack like energy drinks do. In an upcoming video, I will talk about the risks of energy drinks, because it's just not good, guys. The high potassium and magnesium found in this fruit can help athletes reduce muscle soreness and cramping during and after exercise. You don't have to be an athlete to enjoy these benefits. Surprisingly, not really. Over 68% of Americans don't consume the recommended daily intake of magnesium. Magnesium is needed for over 300 enzyme biochemical reactions in the body. I know some of you out there get Charlie horses while Netflixing, so eat more bananas! Bananas are high in vitamin B6, which is essential for synthesizing heme. Heme is the protein part of hemoglobin that carries iron and oxygen in the blood, which can help reduce anemia. This is also useful for athletic performance. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to hit like on this video. It lets me know you guys are interested in these types of videos. What's your favorite banana recipe? Have bananas helped you on your health journey? Leave a comment below. Peanut butter banana smoothie was actually the first smoothie I ever made in a cheap $20 blender. If you're new, be sure to subscribe for future videos, and thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Stay motivated and thrive, my fellow urban survivors. Bye.